yung chief of police ng Asunción ay nakita nila bakit may pee out dito na wala namang clearance.
The office of the vice governor plays a minimal role in the financial assistance process by submitting only a request to the DSWD for the release of cash assistance in the province. It is essential to clarify that the identification, assessment, validation, and distribution of cash assistance to beneficiaries are exclusively within the DSWD role.
To this August body, regarding po doon sa nangyayaring pee out ng AX program ng DSWD doon sa municipality ng Asunción, Davao del Norte noong October 28. Ito po ay nakarating sa akin na ang mga beneficiary doon ay hindi taga munisipyo ng Asunción. Ito po ay mga tao galing sa munisipyo ng Kapalong. At dinala doon sa gym ng Asunción. Then pinadlock nila yung gym, yung harapan. Parang pinalabas nila na walang tao doon sa loob. Doon lahat pumasok, dumaan sa parang may maliit na entrance exit doon. Sikreto. Walang mga sasakyan naka-parking. I-clear ko lang po ito, Mr. Chair. Walang mga sasakyan naka-parking. Doon sa malayo naka-park yung mga sasakyan. Pagkatapos, yung chief of police ng Asunción ay nakita nila bakit may pee out dito na wala namang clearance. So, ngayon, nagkabulabuga na, Mr. Chair. So, tumawag na ako kay Mayor Maria Teresa Timbol. Nandito rin siya kasama ko ngayon. So, sabi niya, oh, hinakot yung mga tao dito sa Kapalong, sa munisipyo ko, hinakot, dinala doon sa Asunción. So, tumawag ako kay PD, nandoon na ang pulis, nag-action na pala sila dahil parang may malicious talaga sa pee out. So nung nandoon na Mr. Chair, nagpadala rin ako ng abogado, nandito rin kasama ko yung mga abogado na pinadala ko. Nandoon yung tauhan ng taga DSWD. Ayaw pa magbigay ng ID. Niyakap yung bag nila, nandyan yung pera, yung mga document. Ayaw nila ibigay yung kanilang identity.
Can you say identity ng DSWD?
Yes po.
Sigurado ka, DSWD.
Yes po, DSWD.
Dalawang personality. May yes. DSWD ng national, mayroong SWD ng yes lokal, ng munisipyo. So, categorically, you are saying yes. That it is DSWD national.
DSWD, Region 11.
Bakit ayaw nila ibigay yung pangalan nila?
Ayaw ibigay. Tapos, Mr. Chair, dumating pa si Attorney Vanessa Gokong, ang ating regional director ng DSWD, may video po ako, Mr. Chair. Nandoon siya, nirescue niya yung mga tauhan niya. Nirescue niya.
Why? Are they under attack? Were they under attack?
Takot siya na ma-inquest, Mr. Chair. Dinala niya, pinalabas. Nandito naman si Ikuan. May video po ako. Nandito din yung attorney ko. May blatter rin ang ating provincial director dito. Sabi pa niya, bakit daw pinatagalan pa na ipalabas yung kuha niya, yung mga tauhan niya, Mr. Chair. So, doon pa man, Mr. Chair, masabi ko na illegal po yung distribution kasi kung legal yon, pinagpatuloy sana yung pag-distribute sa pera. Well, yung nangyaring distribution, Mr. Chair, to be clear, ako ang gobernur ng Davao del Norte, nandito po ang mayor ng Kapalong, beneficiary niya doon, constituents niya. Wala pong nangyaring sunog, walang nangyaring baha. In short, walang nangyaring calamity. At yung mga pinatawag, Mr. Chair, hindi po validated na dumaan sa process.
Okay.
So, sigurado po.
Yeah, thank you.
Your constituents went to the gym in Asunción?
Somebody texted me.
Was it confirmed?
Because it was already, the information was that there were padlock inside the municipal gym of Asunción. And they could not go out.
Did you go there?
Yes, sir. To verify.
Did you see your constituents there?
Yes, sir. In fact, I was not able to enter immediately because the doors were locked. Mm-hmm. I have informed the police.
What was the reason why they padlocked the doors?
I don't know, sir, because when I went there, the gym was already padlocked. And my constituents could not go out.
Did you introduce yourself that you're the mayor of Kapalong? Kapalong?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
I asked my bodyguard inform somebody inside that the mayor of Kapalong is outside. I wanted to go inside the gym.
Oh, what happened?
And when I went inside.
Ah, pinapasok din kayo eventually?
Yes po.
Alright.
So yun po, nakita ko yung mga taga-Kapalong po nandoon.
Oh, what was their situation?
Some of them, I asked them, some of them arrived there in the morning. Some at 1 in the afternoon.
Hindi, sino ang nag-recruit sa kanila papunta rin sa gym?
We're informed that the leaders of the barangay officials who are running for the barangay election po. It's not our MSWDO.
So you did not choose the beneficiaries of the
No, Your Honor.
IX program?
No, Your Honor.
Who were the ones who chose it? The barangay leaders?
Yeah, the barangay leaders.
Didn't the barangay leaders inform you about it?
No, sir.
Wala ba mo wala?
No information at all.
Huh?
No naman po.
Walang nagsabi ni... Ilan ba barangay ninyo?
14 po.
So, you mean to say lahat ng mga barangays mo represented dun sa...
Yes po. Yung naglista, yung mga kalaban po ng mga barangay captains.
Yung mga kalaban mo?
Yes po.
Yung 14 barangay captains, kalaban mo lahat?
Hindi naman po. During that time, I have, out of 14, I have 12 incumbent barangay officials.
Alright, did you interview your constituents?
Yes,
when you went there?
Yes, sir.
What did you ask them?
Are you here? Yes, sir.
Oh, what did they say?
They said that the leader of that barangay official listed them.
Alright.
And their barangay to go to the municipality of Asuncion.
You do not have any gym there? In your
we have town. Lots, sir. Plenty of gym.
Oh.
All the barangays.
Bakit hindi doon nag payout? Bakit sa Asuncion pa? Sa Asuncion pa?
I think yung mga nag-organize, they can answer your question po.
Sino ba nag-organize? The SWD? Okay, I will go to that matter. Alright. When you interviewed your constituents, halos lahat yan tiga Kapalong?
Yes, sir.
Lahat yan walang tiga ibang bayan? Oh, Kapalong lang?
I guess so, sir. Lahat ng taga-Kapalong.
Magkano rin tinanggap nila? What did you ask them?
Sabi nila, there were almost 100 that were paid out already.
Alright.
With the amount of 2,000 pesos.
Magkano supposedly, Yusek, yung payout? Magkano dapat tatanggapin nila?
2,000 po.
So 2,000?
Yes po. But the payout was made on October 28. That was 2 days away from the barangay election po.
Okay. So lahat yung mga, ilan sila nung nakita niya sa gym?
I guess with the rough estimate, I would say 400 to 500 persons po.
400 to 500?
Yes po.
Persons? Ang...
Kasi halos puno po yung gym po ng, na
asosyon. So nakausap niyo lahat yung 400?
Hindi po. Hindi po. Only some of them na medyo sa nalalapitan ko lang po.
So they confirmed to you that they received 2,000 pesos?
Yung naiwan po doon is hindi na po nakatanggap kasi yung unang tumanggap is nakaalis na po sa gym.
So sa tingin niyo, yung mga unang nakatanggap na nakaalis, nakatanggap din ng 2,000?
Yes po. According to those people inside na naabutan ko po.
Senator Jingoy, if I may. Mayor, yun nga, nakita mo, pinadlak. Tapos nandun ka, nakita mo mga tao mo, nakita mo, nalaman mo na yung mga nagdala nito, mga tao na ito ay mga leaders ng barangay kapitan na hindi mo kaalyado.
Yes,
so meaning, kalaban mo sa politika.
Opo, yes, Your Honor.
Hindi ka, after that, hindi ka pumunta sa local kumilik, nag-complain that this is 2 days prior to election. This is a clear violation of the Omnibus Election Code. Hindi ka pa pumunta sa kumilik at nag-complain?
There were lawyers, sir, who also arrived doon sa...
Lawyers ng?
Ng... From the kay Gob Ubahib po.
Tapos?
Then, in fact, there was a small group.
Ay, hindi ba man yun, hindi man yung lawyer mo. Hindi yung lawyer ng kumilig. Dapat, it should be incumbent on your part na mag-complain sa kumilig. May local kumilig ba kayo doon eh? Pinutahan mo saan at tinanong mong kumilig. Is this authorized by kumilig? Is this a payout legal? Is this payout not violative to the Omnibus Election Code? Dapat mayroong klarong sagot galing sa kumilig 2 days prior to election. Hindi mo ginawa yan.
Hindi na po. Basta, yeah. Is the government...
Pero why, ikaw na, yeah, nagtanong kayo sa kumilig, sa local kumilig doon?
Yes, Your Honor, nag-file po agad ako sa provincial Comelec chairperson. At kaya nga, formally filed ito sa office po ng ating national chairman, Comelec chairman. Dahil po yung provincial Comelec chairperson ay nagsabi sa akin na hindi po nila pinayagan kasi yung mga distribution ng AX. Kahit nga ayuda galing sa probinsya, Your Honor, ay prohibited po kami na mamigay.
Bakit nangyari yun? Kung ayaw, sabi ng Comelec, hindi pwede.
Ang sabi nga ng DSWD, may exemption daw sila. Pinakita pa doon sa PNP ng Davao del Norte. At sa katunayan po, may video tayo na nandoon yung mga Comelec officer galing sa kung payagan nyo po, issue ko po yung video, dumating po si Regional Director Attorney Vanessa Gukong, nandoon po ang tauhan ni Vice Governor Oyuoy na si Peer at si Mr. Caminero na nagfacilitate doon sa payout.
Well,
okay. This humble representation senator would like to address recent allegations regarding financial assistance payout conducted by DSWD in our province. These accusations claim that the Office of the Vice Governor manipulated the said payout to the detriment of beneficiaries engaging in actions inconsistent with principles of transparency and equitable distribution. The distribution of financial assistance are normally given to qualified individuals, just like what DSWD said earlier. Insinuations against me suggest that I utilize the financial assistance payout to deceive beneficiaries into receiving less than the amount earmarked for them. I vehemently deny these allegations, Honorable Senators. The Office of the Vice Governor plays a minimal role in the financial assistance process by submitting only a request to the DSWD for the release of cash assistance in the province. It is essential to clarify that the identification, assessment, validation and distribution of cash assistance to beneficiaries are exclusively within the DSWD role, a national government agency. Role of the Vice Governor is only limited to expressing the needs of constituents and forwarding requests to different government agencies, such as but not limited to the DSWD. Any insinuation or interference or manipulation on my part during the financial payout process is categorically untrue. In response to allegations regarding the release of cash assistance between October 19 to 30, 2023, I also sought clarification from the DSWD, and it was confirmed that the financial assistance distributed during that period was routinary, sir. In fact, it was said by the DSWD personnel here present. In light of the insinuations, I initiated also my own investigation, requesting documents and conducting interviews with cash assistance beneficiaries. Findings revealed that beneficiaries who purportedly claimed to have received less than expected had in fact received the full amount. The confusion stemmed from misunderstanding wherein some beneficiaries expected a different amount than what they were entitled to. To address concerns, the Ninth Sangguniang Panlalawigan of Davao del Norte, under my leadership as presiding officer, likewise held a special ad hoc committee hearing on November 9, 2023 to discuss the distribution of financial assistance, specifically the incident in Asuncion, Davao del Norte, and to address the Honorable Governor's complaints regarding Comelec violations. So during the special ad hoc committee meeting, witnesses of the beneficiaries of the payout testified that elements of Asuncion Municipal Police Office under the directive of Police Major Bryle Patalinghog were responsible in closing the doors of Asuncion Municipal Gym with an estimated 600 people inside, more or less.
Sandali, stop ka muna dyan.
Yes, sir.
Pwede Davao del Norte, Totoo ba yung sinasabi niya na police ang nagpadlock?
Good morning, sir.
May presence ng kandidato doon sa distribution. Yung po yung pinagbabawal namin, yung po yung bawal na mag-distribute na kayo na mag-distribute, wala kaming pakialam. Pero kapag may presence ng kandidato 2 days before the election, ibang usapan po yun. So gusto lang namin malaman, hopefully, as we go on with the investigation, malaman po namin yung katotohanan. Kasi ibig sabihin, pagka po ganun, nagagamit halimbawa ang distribution sa pamamulit. Kaya yun nga po yung pinagbabawal namin. Kaya po, kanina nagulat lang po ako yung sabihin na may presence ng mga kandidato doon.
Was there candidates present during the distribution?
Mr. Chair, Senator, may I be allowed to speak? I was not present during that incident. Nagpa-check up ko sa ako ang... But I know that Mayor Timbol was there present during that said activity.
No problem. Ang ibig sabihin ni Chairman, Kumilig Chairman na kandidato, yung mga barangay kapitan.
Yes, okay.
Because that was barangay kapitan election, di ba? Okay. Barangay election.
Barangay SK.
Barangay SK election. So, sino yung nagsabi na mayroong mga kandidato nandun? Ikaw ba, Mayor? Mayor Timbol?
No, I did not mention, Your Honor.
Sinong...
But yung mga previous pa rin na mga payouts nila, mga mass payouts, hindi po talaga siya dumadaan sa aming MSWD o iba po yung nag-a-identify doon sa barangays. Kaya sabi doon mga qualified beneficiaries, hindi namin alam ngayon, who are the qualified beneficiaries? Kasi we are used to ask talaga assistance to the SWD in times of calamity, tulad may mga wash out na mga bahay, partially or totally damaged, nagbibigay ng rice. But never po nangyari in our municipality na walang disaster, walang calamity, nagnamamas payout. It's not only in October 28. There were previous payouts pa rin, mass payouts ng the SWD. Ayun po, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mayor. You want to say something?
Yes, Your Honor. During the payout of AEX or any forms of ayuda coming from the SWD, bago po mamimigay, mag-release ng pera, nandoon po sila si Vice Governor Uyuy na magsalita kasama yung lineup niya sa local hanggang barangay captains. At may propo ako dyan lahat, Your Honor. And yung nangyari doon sa Asuncion, ang presence po doon, yung chief of staff niya, si... Sino yung per? Persona. Personal chief of staff niya, si Persona. Makita po kung payagan niyo yung video at yung si... sa office staff niya, sa Vice Governor's office, si Caminero.
Sino yung pangalan?
Robert Caminero, na taga-Kapalong.
Very good, no? We will allow you to show that video later. Pero klaruhin natin, Vice Governor Uyuy is not running for barangay SK elections, di ba? Yung staff niya, hindi rin tumatakbo. Ang gusto natin malaman ngayon, kung yung mga kapitan, nasabi mo na nasa line-up ni Vice Gov, kung nandoon sa payout.
Yes.
Because yan ang
protocol natin. Nandoon po yung mga...
May proof ka na.
May proof ako, Your Honor.
During the duration of the prohibition?
Yes po. During sa election from October 20 to 30 po.
Meron mga kandidato?
Mga barangay candidate po, Your Honor. At sila po yung nag-re-recruit doon po sa maging beneficiary sa payout.
Do you confirm, Vice Governor?
I was not there during those said payouts, Your Honor. And as to the barangay leaders present, I vehemently deny, Your Honor.
Okay, we will take that up later. Your excuse, Chairman Garcia. And thank you. Thank you for your presence.
Maraming salamat po.
Thank you. You may continue.
Thank you.
Vice Governor Uyuy.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair. I would like to continue with regards to the Asuncion incident. Wherein estimated 600 people were padlocked. The truth of the matter about that, Mr. Chair, as per Major Brial Patalinghog, there was a report of vote buying. So ang ginawa nila, nagresponde daw yung police doon. Pag-check doon ang police, nakita DSWD personnel and around 600 people. So tinanong nila si DSWD, may exemption po ba kayo nito? So until nangyari, pinadlock nila from 2 p.m. to 8:30 in the evening lahat ng mga tao na andoon. Moreover, the COMELEC supervisor of Asuncion, Mr. Marcelino Cortez, were unable to heed and take cognizance of the presented documents po ni DSWD Regional Director Vanessa Gokong, of which na-mention niya kanina yung mga COMELEC exemptions po. The presentation of such documents should have facilitated na mapatuloy po yung payout and early opening of the gate and doors of the gym, which would have eventually shortened the agony sa ating mga individuals po na nangangailangan ng tulong. Likewise, during the said investigation, Police Major Patalinghog admitted that he is responsible in giving instruction to his men to close the gym upon orders sa taas po. Honorable Governor even admitted on social media that the purpose of the closure of the gym was to prevent ingress and egress of DSWD staff and beneficiaries. Additionally po, sinabi po ni Police Major Patalinghog, dumating po doon around 10 p.m. si Honorable Governor together with lawyers and allegedly had the incident blotted in the police file po. Furthermore, according to identified beneficiaries of DSWD payout presented as witness during the special ad hoc committee, the elected officials who were mentioned in the baseless and called for responsible statements of Honorable Governor on social media were not physically present in the venue. Yet in his official public statements, Governor Hubaib repeatedly insinuated po that these officials were malfeasance of alleged illegal payouts. So to further, Mr. President, and to the Honorable Senators, it has also come to my attention that the beneficiaries who executed affidavits in support of the governor's complaint were perjured. These beneficiaries informed me that they were enticed with promise of monetary benefits, misled and or intimidated to execute affidavits. Based on their admissions, it seems that the complaint made by the Honorable Governor of Davao del Norte is nothing more than a mere political harassment. And I have here, in fact, 15 beneficiaries belonging to District 1 na nag-execute po ng kanilang perjured affidavits. And I have one witness.
Pakalan ka?
Yes po, meron po kaming affidavits dito. Then we have one witness po dito na nadala din po namin. If needed po, Senator.
Yeah, we will
Yes po.
Give him time to speak before okay. This committee. We'll listen to him.
Okay. So before I make my final statements po, it is very unfortunate that the story about this incident and as well as local politics dami po na drug, even ang atin po mga different government agencies, when in fact the province now is under a state of calamity. Mr. Senator, you well very know na nag-straight po yung ulan po sa atin and marami na pong nabahaan sa Davao del Norte, and yet ang two of the officials in the province is here today na naglalabayan po na ay naglabayay po lapok sa isa't isa, when in fact we should be with each other helping our constituents in Davao del Norte po. So aside from the two highest ranking officials, even the SWD, we really need their help today. And in this moment, Mr. President, it's because we have more than 59,000 affected families po ng baha po dahil yung shear line po. So finally, I reiterate my commitment to transparency, fairness, and adherence to the rule of law. Office of the Vice Governor remains dedicated to serving the people and upholding the integrity of government programs. As to din po yung sinabi po ni COMELEC Chair kanina na naghingi po ako ng exemption, it is not this program po. It's a program of the Office of the Vice Governor, not this DSWD program yung hiningaan ko po ng exemption. It's just my program po.
Thank you.